Hi, welcome to another spine animation theory video. It's time to learn another animation principle. In this video, we'll talk about the wave principle and see how it connects with the other principles. The wave principle is not one of the 12 basic animation principles, but you will still use it in most of your animations. In time, you will see that it is used everywhere, not only in flags, tails, hair, and so on, but also in body mechanics, shifting weight, and even facial animation. So let's jump into spine and see how some of its features can help us understand and work with the wave principle. Let's start with a simple tail animation and build up from there. First, I will create a bone and split it into 10 nested bones. Next, I will rotate the bones to the left on frame 0, key the same on frame 38 to get a loop, and then go to frame 19 and rotate the chain to the right. What we have doesn't look like a very nice tail animation, even if we change the curves to Bezier. The reason is that all the parts are moving at the same time. Putting the tail aside for a moment, let's take a ball, animate it moving up and down, duplicate it 10 times, and offset each ball 2 frames. This gives us a nice wave motion. Instead of all the balls moving together, each ball lags behind the one before it slightly. We can use this knowledge to improve the tail animation. What we need is to offset the keys so each bone starts rotating after the bones higher in the bone hierarchy. To do that, we can use spine's offset feature. I will move each bone 2 frames to get a nice and even loop. Now we have a smooth, nice-looking tail animation. This animation is pretty straightforward and it's easy to create using the offset feature, but many times you will not be so lucky. Often you'll have an uneven cycle or no cycle at all, and so the offset feature won't be able to help you. In that case, you need to understand more about the movements that make up wave motion. When the wave animation is a cycle, like our tail animation, the first thing to notice is that the tip doesn't move back and forth evenly. Instead, it moves in a figure 8 pattern. Next, it is helpful to think of the wave motion being created because the lower part of the tail is leading the action while the upper part is just being dragged. If I simplify and transfer the motion to a ball for the top and bottom parts, I get something like this. This shows that the upper ball follows through and overlaps the movement of the lower ball. Even though these balls are not connected, your brain is tricked into imagining a connection between them, thanks to the wave principle. It is important for you to know that wave motion is made up of 4 shapes: an S-curve, reverse C-curve, reverse S-curve, and C-curve. Knowing these basic shapes is how you build good wave movement. Look for these 4 wave shapes and you will find them everywhere. They can be seen in the red balls, the blue balls, and in just about any other animation if you look closely. Keep these shapes in mind when you use wave motion for follow-through and overlapping action. With all that in mind, let's jump into today's exercise. First, I want you to try to animate the wave principle yourself. Here we have the project file you can find in the video description. It has a platform with a tail. Let's animate the platform moving left and right and make the tail follow through. Again, this is very easy using the offset feature. Just make 2 main poses, offset the keys, and it's done. Now, I want you to try to make this animation yourself, without using the offset button. Doing that is pretty tedious and challenging, but it's a necessary step to really understand how the wave principle works. Now that we have warmed up our animation muscles, we can jump into the real assignment. You may have noticed that the exercises we've done in past videos are all pretty challenging. They're all designed to train multiple principles, as is this one. I want you to animate the platform catching a falling ball, then balancing it so the ball doesn't fall off. You will have to be especially careful with the tail hanging from the platform. The tail will make great use of the wave principle you just learned. The difficult part is that this is not a cycle animation, so you will have to animate the tail depending on the movement of the platform for it to look convincing. You cannot pose the tail at the same time as you're posing the platform, because the tail animation depends very heavily on the movement of the platform. The workflow is simple. Animate the platform and the ball first, then, only when you're satisfied with the animation of the platform, should you tackle animating the tail. This same approach should be applied for animating fabric, hair, or any other elements on your character. Always first animate the main part, the driver of the action, and only once you have that right, do you animate the follow-through parts. How the ball and the platform will interact is entirely up to you. You can make it easy on yourself, or really complicate your life, like I have done. Use the power of a spine's preview to test your animation and adjust accordingly. That's the benefit of this exercise. Make a lot of mistakes and learn from them. If you have trouble using curves to make your animation look good, instead try adding many keys to get the shapes needed for the tail. Later, in your polish pass, replace the keys with curves to reduce the number of keys. I use loop start and end to polish only chunks of the animation, so I don't have to think about the entire animation at once. Let's analyze the animation I did for this exercise. I will go through it frame by frame. It's good practice to always come through your animation frame by frame to check your arcs and to see if there are any pops or weird spacing. I start with a small amount of anticipation. Then I use ease out and ease in on every start and stop of the platform. On the ball, I use squash and stretch with other principles like arc, ease out and ease in. I also use ghosting to check my arcs on the tail and the platform throughout the animation. The follow-through and the overlapping action on the tail was achieved by using the wave principle. You can see how many animation principles are intertwined, and our job as an animator is to know when and how to utilize them. There are many ways to animate tails, flags, hair, cloth, and similar objects in spine. Using the offset feature is great, but it's still very important to understand the fundamentals of the wave principle. applying the basic shapes for wave motion is necessary to build a good tail or wave animation. Have fun and happy animating!